Hey guys, welcome back. This round we're going to tackle the fuel lines, the throttle, getting the wiring harness tested, things like that, just to make sure everything's ready to start the engine. So follow along as we do that.
Just real quick, I'll show you the brake booster line. Typically it comes through this little hole right here in the firewall, but have it routed going beneath this little cutout in the firewall, and basically just use the one-way valve to a very small amount of hose. This is the Subaru brake booster hose, and I just cut a short little section. Then we're gonna secure it up here so it doesn't rub on anything, and that'll give us plenty of clearance when we go to mount the intake tubing. Here is the supply fuel line. I actually have it coming through where the charcoal canister vacuum connection, the little vacuum solenoid, came through. But I pushed that to the other side of the firewall, and I'm going to run those lines back over here. In any case, the fuel line comes up this direction and connects up here. I've capped these two off. This one's for the purge solenoid. This is for if you're going to use the Subaru charcoal canister, and there's actually a solenoid that operates, but we're not going to use that. We're just going to remain VW on that side. Okay, and then this is the return fuel line, and I've actually capped it. I actually like running the return over on this side, and some other garbage in the way, but here's the return line right here. Comes right here, sneaks underneath the engine harness here, and actually connects to the fuel regulator right here. So right there you can see. So I like doing it that way. It just keeps the line a little shorter, and in my mind, why wrap it around all the way across the engine to come out here when then you have to go all the way back to that side of the tank? Just for reference, here's a fuel pressure regulator. This one's off EJ22, but they're basically the same thing. This is this nipple right here, the bigger one. That is the return line. This guy plugs into the fuel rail with the O-ring there. And then this guy gets intake vacuum off of the intake plenum. So in the bus currently, or the van currently, it's sitting like this, kind of like that. But you could theoretically flip it around so that it's going straight. All right, look at this unwrapped harness. Pretty gnarly, huh? Anyway, I like to test my harness before I wrap it, just because in case I find something that I need to change up, I'm able to correct it without having to do a bunch of work unwrapping it. In any case, right now I have the ECU just sitting right there, and all the relevant connections, so ignition on, battery on, key, trigger, and fuel pump, which is right here, and it actually swings over to the fuel pump. That is all connected, and fired it up, and it's runs well. Keep in mind, I'm only firing it up just to see if the ignition is working, all the cam and crank sensors are working, and the actual fuel injectors are working. So I'm not heating it up, not starting it for long periods of time. It's for probably about 10 seconds at the most, 5 or 10 seconds. So this harness, for basic functionality, is working great. So now I'm gonna disassemble it all, take it out of the van, and then wrap it, and then kind of show you what I did, and then how to connect it over here. Here's the harness with its final wrap up to a certain point. These connect to the engine here, and that guy connects to the O2 sensors, and then we come back just a touch and we have the barometric sensor. It's gonna go right there, and then this lead goes to the black box in the left of the engine compartment, and this is all the goodies for gauges and you know, the start wire, ignition, stuff like that. So here we have the wrap, and I'm gonna start feeding it through the right underneath the cabinets and getting it into the engine bay. The wiring harness is in. You can see it's going through the grommet here, and it comes down and is attached to the wall here and connects to the engine connectors. And then we have the barometric pressure sensor, and most of the wiring goes through this little barrel connector. I just clipped it and then crimped on the connectors here. Now these are for like the oil light, water temperature, things of that nature. They all go through here. I'll try and make a diagram and post that probably on my website. Okay, then we have a battery positive going through a fuse holder and connecting to the stud here. And I need to wait for another fuse holder, but that needs to connect to ignition on. This black wire came from the coil, or from the key to the coil. And in this case, we're not using that coil anymore, obviously. So it just connects to the ignition wire on the Subaru side. Then from the fuel pump relay, we have this black and yellow wire, and I haven't loomed it yet. It's not actually connected yet, but it's going to travel on the inside of the firewall, and you can see it right here. It actually is going to meet up with the alternator ignition on source, this guy here, it's red and blue, and that's going to connect to the fuel pump wire. So if we follow the alternator's wiring, this is all just loomed up. It has the VW connectors on it right there. So that goes to the starter. And then it also goes to this guy here. But anyway, we have the blue wire that comes out over here. And that's going to connect to ignition on. And then we have this black and white wire, which is the alternator light. So that's going up all the way to the dash. And I just spliced that in to the VW one. Now that the wiring harness is mostly figured out, we just need the lead that goes to the O2 sensors. I'm going to wait until I get the exhaust in to put that in, though. We're going to take a look at the intake. So this is just a silicone elbow, and it's going to wrap around and come to the stock Subaru airbox. Now originally it sits right behind the engine right there on the Forester. On the Legacies, it actually sits over here, if you're looking at it in the Subaru, with the mass airflow sensor. But seeing as how this one relies on a MAP map sensor, we don't need that box. But what we're gonna do is just link that up with some pipe. And here's what I'm using. Pretty common use. It's a intercooler tubing, and you can get these on eBay. They're pretty reasonable. This is black aluminum, anodized aluminum, and they come with silicone couplers, elbows, things like that. Anyway, that's gonna go like that. It's all measured out and pre-fit. I'm just leaving it off for now, just while I finalize a few other things. Next up is working on the throttle assembly. You can find detailed instructions at Busaru.com or BoxerSwaps.com. Basically, it's just going to merge the stock VW throttle cable to the Subaru and then flip this assembly so that it works. When you press on the pedal, it'll pull. Basically, the wheel is going to move over here so that the angles match up correctly. Here's the throttle assembly all finished here. What I did was just cut the VW cable and splice it into the Subaru cable. And this one's the large barrel. And just use some shrink wrap to make sure that the cables don't fray. And then at full throttle, this will rub just slightly on this guy, but I wanted to leave a little bit of length just to make sure, just to keep some adjustability. In any case, works like a charm. All the spring tension and everything is great. There's a little bit of play in the cable, which is a good thing. And this wheel is for cruise control if it's ever decided to be used.